بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. So the Shaykh, جزاهم الله خير, he just finished Surah, the Surah that we talked about yesterday, last night, the very last Surah that we talked about was Surah Al-Zukhruf. And he just started a new Surah, Surah Al-Dukhan. Very well known Surah. We're still with the Hawameem, those that start with Hameem. So today, inshallah, he will cover Surah Hameem, Surah Al-Jathiya, and then Surah Al-Ahqaf, and Surah Muhammad, the very little bit of Surah Muhammad. So, no? All of it. All, يعني خمس سورز. Five. We just finished Al-Zukhruf, and then we'll cover Hameem, Al-Jathiya, and Al-Ahqaf, and Surah Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All these surahs, in less than 10 minutes, inshallah ta'ala. So those are Makki surahs. All of them are Makki surahs except Surah Muhammad. Surah Muhammad is a Madani surah, which means it was revealed in Medina. But Surah Al-Ahqaf, Surah Jathiya, Surah Al-Dukhan are all Makki surahs, and they're all from the Mathani, yani 100, less than 100 verses. With regard to Surah Al-Dukhan, Dukhan is smoke. It's one of the major signs of the hereafter. How many major signs are they? The major signs of the hereafter. How many? How many? Who said that? I heard somebody say it here. Yeah?
Ten.
Ten major signs. Surah Al-Dukhan is one of them. Not Surah Al-Dukhan. Dukhan, the smoke, is one of them. As it will come at the very, very last, in fact, one of the very last signs where this smoke will come and take the soul of only the believers, and who would remain on earth, only the non-believers, wa'idhu billah, upon them, the Qiyamah will start. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the Qiyamah will start only on those non-believers. So this Dukhan, although it's a major sign, but it will take the smoke, or it will take, I'm sorry, the soul of the believers, leaving only non-believers on earth. Anyway, Surah Al-Dukhan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about in Surah Al-Dukhan again, one more time, Musa alayhi salam, the story of Musa alayhi salam. And he talks about, as we said yesterday in Surah Al-Zukhruf, the not to be deceived with the materialistic world, such as, you know, gold and silver and whatnot. Here with Surah Al-Dukhan, not to be deceived or through the power and authority. This thing, this surah manifests, you know, through the love of power and authority. Comes in who? Fir'aun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كم تركوا من جنات وعيون وزروع ومقام كريم. How many jannat they have left behind? How many gardens, how many springs, talking about jannah, they have missed out on entering into jannah as they chose to not believe in the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the scenes in the hereafter. He talks about one scene in the hellfire and one scene in Jannah. The scene in hellfire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومِ طَعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ كَالْمُهْلِ يَغْلِي فِي الْبُطُونِ كَغَلِّي الْحَمِيمِ. The tree called Zaqqum. There's a tree in Jahannam, وَعِيدُ بِاللَّهِ, may Allah save you and I from it. There's a tree called Zaqqum. In one ayah it says that the description of this Zaqqum, طَلْعُهَا كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. The branches of it as if they are the heads of shayateen. The non-believers will be eating from it. Yes, people will eat in Jahannam, وَعِيدُ بِاللَّهِ. But everything from hellfire is from fire. Food from fire. Clothing, they will be clothed from fire. Everything is from hellfire, it's from fire. But there's this tree called Zaqqum. It's made off of, you know, these thorns. Imagine thorns, and people will be eaten from it. كَغَلِّ الْحَمِيمِ. And then it will be poured on them, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. The juice of it will be poured. It will sever their intestines. It will burn them off, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. And they will not die. And then Allah talks about another scene. The scene of the believers. When Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. So Allah is giving you these two pictures here. Hellfire and then hell. I mean, and then Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says with regard to Jannah, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah is talking about you. Are you listening? Allah is talking about you now. Who wants to go to Jannah? Only one hand. Because if you don't choose to go to Jannah, there's only one more destination, right? You don't want to go there. is either Jannah and then astaghfirullah, hellfire, may Allah save you and I from it. So إن المتقين في مقام أمين في جنات وعيون وزروع في جنات وعيون يلبسون من سندس واستبرق متقابلين. يا سلام متقابلين. They will, this believers, this righteous people, you, Allah is saying, إن المتقين, they'll be in secure place. We all look for security, safety. There is no better security than security in Jannah. في مقام أمين. أمن comes from أمن. أمن means safety and security. You'll be secure right there. There's one more place. If you were to go there, you feel secure. Which place are we talking about? Okay. Two. Who said that? Who said that? Who said? You said?
Yeah.
What did you say?
Mecca.
Yeah. Give it to the cha-cha. To. Aywa. Mecca. Al-Balad al-Amin. Al-Balad Amin. You feel secure when you go to Mecca. You feel safe when you go to Mecca. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي مَقَامٍ أَمِينٍ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ. They will be in these gardens and springs. وَعُيُونٍ يَلْبَسُونَ. They will be attired, the dresses from silk and silk embroidery. All these beauties that is awaiting us, inshaAllah ta'ala, in Jannah. Quickly, so we can move on to Surah Al-Jathiyah. Surah Al-Jathiyah, the theme of the surah talks about the danger of arrogance. Al-Kibr. Kibr in Arabic. You may call it pride, but pride as in arrogance, showing off. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam says, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. He shall not be admitted to Jannah. He who has one atom in his heart, one atom of kibr, of arrogance in his heart. ويل لكل أفاك أثيم. Allah is saying, woe to these liars, to these sinful liars. أفاك أثيم. يسمع آيات الله. He hears, he knows, he hears the آيات of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He hears the signs of Allah azza wa jalla. These prophets who are coming to them and warning them, they hear. But instead of following and adhering to these commands, what do they do? تتلى عليه ثم يصر مستكبرا كأن لم يسمعها مستكبرا. You know, then he turns back, so being arrogant as if he didn't hear it. Sometimes people, they want to come and give you an admonition and say, I know it all. I know. You're going to teach me? Who are you to teach me? Who are you to tell me? You've just been acting a little bit arrogant here. So Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about that. And then at the very end, Allah says in this surah, وَلَهُ الْكِبْرِيَاءُ. This is only something that is befitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُ الْكِبْرِيَاءُ فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Surah Al-Ahqaf. Surah Al-Ahqaf is a very interesting surah. Surah Al-Ahqaf is also from the Hawamim. By the way, I mentioned that yesterday. The surah, the Hawamim, those that start with Hamim. How many surahs are they?
Seven.
Aywa. You must be Egyptian, huh? From Egypt. Yeah, I told this and then he wanted to give it a head. He's a soccer player. Aywa. Hamim, mashallah alayk. But we're going to beat you tomorrow, inshallah. Because Morocco is playing against them. They beat us today. You know, Al Ahli beat my Moroccan team today. But tomorrow we're going to beat them, inshallah. Anyway, tomorrow. I'm just joking with the guy. Surah Al-Hawamin, there are seven of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about in Surah Al-Ahqaf, again about the beauty and the merits of this kitab. The kitab here means Al-Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about this kitab, Al-Quran. الذي خلق السماوات والأرض. الله عز وجل talks about himself as well, سبحانه وتعالى. الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. He created the heavens and earth with the حق, with the truth. Brothers and sisters, there's only two things here. الحق, if you don't follow الحق, you will be with falsehood, الباطل. So choose the path of الحق, then you will be, inshallah تعالى, resurrected upon الحق, with the الحق, سبحانه وتعالى. I will come back to this surah later on. I'm going to quickly talk about Surah Muhammad, the very last surah that the Shaykh will cover today. Surah Muhammad, it speaks for itself. This is the surah that talks about Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam. It is a surah that talks a lot about, at the very end, Ati'u Allah wa Rasul, Ati'u Allah wa Rasul, obey Allah and His Prophet, obey Allah and His Prophet. And then the theme of this particular surah, it talks about the actions that a person can do that will get them close to Allah. The actions that a person can do that will be accepted from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are certain actions that would deprive them, if they were to be done, they would deprive them from the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as if Allah azza wa jalla is telling you and I, whenever he finishes this, a lot of these ayat in Surah Muhammad, obey Allah and his Prophet, obey Allah and his Prophet. Maybe the message here is, one of the actions that will get you close to Allah, one of the main actions that will earn you the pleasure of Allah, is to follow Allah and to follow his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam. And then in Surah Muhammad, Allah azza wa jalla talks about the rivers in Jannah. How many rivers are there in Jannah? 8? No, those are gates. Gates are 8. How many rivers? 4? Who says 4? 1? There's only 1. Why, akhi, are you, a little bit miser, a little bit stingy? Jannah, aywa, how many? 12? And I'm gonna go through all the numbers now. No, actually Allah mentions, na'am, who said 4? 4, but there's more than 4. Because you forgot to mention one more. One more river called? Al-Kawthar. Al-Kawthar, okay, 5, here we go. 5, aywa, 5, here we go. 5. So, one river, Allah mentions one river from? Min ma'in ghayri asin, from water, beautiful water. And then the second river is from? Hani, 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 habibi, hani. From hani, musaffa. This is pure honey. Not that, no, this is pure sunny. And then the third river is from? Milk. Where does milk come from, boys? Where does milk come from? Cow and what else? Camels, goats. Milk in Jannah does not come from cow, nor camel, nor goat. It comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So is the water. So we have water, we have milk, we have honey. And the fourth river is from? From alcohol. From alcohol. Khamr, ladhatin lishalibin. It is not that alcohol that will make you cuckoo. No. It is the alcohol, actually, ladhat lishalibin. It's not, it will not intoxicate you. It is the other type of alcohol. Brothers and sisters, an ayah that will change your life. An ayah that will change your life. This is in Surah Al-Ahqaf, verse number 13. Verse number 13. You ready? By the way, in Surah Al-Ahqaf, Allah also talks about this jinn. When Prophet Muhammad was coming back from a ta'if, and then he was narrating the Quran, reciting the Quran, and Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions about a bunch of jinn. They were walking around, or they were just driving around, and then they heard Prophet Muhammad reciting the Quran, and they came. This is the part of the book of Allah, the part of the Quran. They heard the message, they heard the Quran, they believed in the message of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and then they start calling one another, Ya qawmi ajibu da'i Allah, Ya qawmana ajibu da'i Allah, O people, jinn, ajibu, answer the call of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Brothers and sisters, verse number 13 from Surah Ahqaf. Verse number 13 from Surah Al-Ahqaf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ أُولَئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Remember this. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ, those who say our Lord is Allah, and then they remain in the state of steadfastness. Please underline this word, steadfastness. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. استقامت, as you say maybe in Urdu, استقامة. What will happen to them? فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They have nothing to fear, nothing to be sad, nothing to feel in this dunya, and nothing to feel in the akhirah. أولئك أصحاب الجنة, the other people of Jannah, they will be admitted to Jannah, هم فيها خالدون. And Allah says, why? جزاء بما كانوا يعملون, in the reward for that which they used to do. You see, all this time that you're taking from your busy time, from your busy schedule, to come and pray, to wake up for Fajr, to make your wudu, and to walk out, to drive to the masjid, to fast, to make dhikr, to give sadaqah. This is not easy. You're making lots of effort. In return, what will happen? جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. But the key word is, as you've been coming in Ramadan, and mashallah, making the masjid look so beautiful, packed and whatnot, this is what we call steadfastness. What are you going to do after Ramadan? Are you going to remain steadfast? Because if you remain steadfast, this ayah applies to you. If you're going to keep coming to the masjid like you used to in Ramadan, don't quit. Please, I beg you, don't quit.
This is the masjid of Allah Azza wa Jal. Keep coming to this masjid. Make this masjid look so beautiful with your presence, inshallah ta'ala. Don't let these pillars cry after Ramadan, because they will miss you. Be in the state of steadfastness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall grant you Jannat al-Firdaus bi-idhnillah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.